Very good.
Yes.
Ooh. I keep forgetting we don't.
That was my don't act so depressed.
I didn't mean it like that.
I mean,
it's just weird to me. For 4 years, I have.
Okay, let's call this meeting to order. Please stand for the invocation, the Pledge of Allegiance, and the Texas Pledge.
Thank you, Mayor. Let's pray. Father, we are grateful for your guidance and love. And Lord, we pray for all of our neighbors in Corinth. And more than anything, we want to thank you for the blessings that you have bestowed on our wonderful city. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Citizens' comments. Please limit your comments to 3 minutes. Comments about any of the council agenda items are appreciated by the council and may be taken into consideration at this time or during that agenda item. Council is prohibited from acting on or discussing items brought before them at this time.
I don't have anything there.
Are there any citizens' comments? No? Okay. Consent agenda. I'd entertain a motion on the consent agenda.
Mayor, I make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Any comment? Catch your vote. Doesn't work? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. It's unanimous. Public hearing. Conduct a public hearing to consider testimony and act on the ordinance amending section 2.10.09 C.2.B. PD, plan development application and review of the city unified development code, case number GTA 24-001-UDC amendment. Mr. Campbell.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. Tonight, our Director of Planning and Development, Melissa Daly, will present this item, explain the ordinance, answer any questions you have.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. This is fairly straightforward. It's to consider the removal of a particular statement in our UDC that states that narrative components of the PD's design statement are supporting information for staff and elected or appointed officials and will not be included in the adopted PD ordinance. What we found is sometimes that background information really helps when we're looking at PDs at a later time and we're working with the developer and trying to make sure that what's implemented is what was intended in the PD. So we would like to be able to incorporate those items that we feel would be particularly relevant down the road when we're going through the development process. P&Z
Are there any questions, Council? And entertain a motion on this item?
Open the public.
Oh, gotta have public. Okay. This time we'll open this for public hearing. Is there anybody in the audience that would like to speak to this issue? Not? Close the public hearing. I entertain a motion on this item.
Mayor, I would move to approve ordinance number 24-02-15-07. Case number ZTA 24-0001 as presented.
I'll second.
Any further discussion? Cast your vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. It's unanimous. Business agenda. Consider an act and an ordinance of the City of Corinth, Texas, calling for a joint general election with Denton County to be held on Saturday, May 4th, 2023, for the purpose of electing one council member for place 1, place 3, and place 4 to serve as a member on the Corinth City Council and authorize the city manager to execute the necessary documents to effectuate the intent of this ordinance. Mr. Campbell.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. Mayor, as you said, this ordinance is to call the election. It's actually for May 4th, 2024. That's incorrectly stated on the agenda header. However, your ordinance states it correctly, so I think we're fine. But this is for place 1, 3, and 4 on the City Council. Just a note that place 3 will be for place 3 will be for a one-year term. The other for two-year terms. The other for three-year terms, and then they all will be three-year terms after that. One-year term is up. So.
Okay. I entertain a motion on that item.
Mayor, I move to approve ordinance number 24-02-15-08, calling a general election for the purpose of electing city council places 1, 3, and 4.
I'll second.
Any further discussion? Cast your vote.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Thank you. Any vote? Okay. It's unanimous. Item number 4, consider an act on an ordinance of the city of Corinth, Texas, calling for a purpose of submitting to the qualified voters of the city of Corinth, Texas, for the adoption or rejection, a proposition adopting a ceiling or limitations on the city's ad lorem tax levy applying to persons 65 years of age or older who receive a homestead exemption subject to the tax ceiling or limitations and authorize the city manager to execute the necessary documents to effectuate the intent of this ordinance. Mr. Campbell.
Thank you, Mayor and Council. This item is related to the petition that the city secretary received a few months ago that we reported to you for this ballot measure. And so this ballot measure would be included on the election that you just called, and just quickly it would be the language for the actual measure is in your ordinance that I can read for you. It is for or against authorizing the adoption of a ceiling or limitation on the city ad valorem tax levy of a person who is 65 years of age or older, who makes application for and receives a homestead exemption. As you know, the city secretary we went to Denton County, and they helped us verify the signatures, and there were enough signatures to put this on the ballot. So that's what this item is.
Okay. I'd entertain a motion on this item.
Mayor, I move to approve ordinance number 24-02-15-09.
I'll second.
Any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, same sign. It passes unanimously. Council comment and future agenda items. The purpose of this section is to allow each council member the opportunity to provide general updates and our comments to fellow council members, the public, and our staff on any issue or future events. Also, in accordance with Section 30.085 of the Code of Ordinances, at this time, any council member may direct that an item be added as a business item to any future agenda. Mr. Burke.
Nothing, Mayor. Thank you.
Mr. Garber.
Nothing, sir. Thank you.
Mr. Holsworth.
Nothing, Mayor. Thank you.
Mrs. Henderson.
I just want to thank you for presenting to the chamber yesterday. It was a great job and lots of good information.
Thank you. Mrs. Pickens.
Got nothing, Mayor. Thank you.
Good to see you back. Mr. Campbell.
Mayor, very quickly, if I could, I just want to embarrass, I guess, Lana and congratulate her for completing her municipal clerk's certification. Those of you that know what that is, it is a long process. It takes years to get that certification. 4 different versions of coursework with 50 hours of homework each, exams and webinars and in-person training, and we really appreciate your dedication getting that done. And I think most of y'all know she was coming down the home stretch on that while she was dealing with some other stuff, so we really appreciate your dedication.
At this time, we're going to executive session, and under items, (clears throat) 551-071, and that's Fairview Swim Club. and Section 551.074, Personnel Matters. City Manager Duties, Oversight Regarding Personnel and Department Structure. Okay, we're into executive session.